Thanks for that, John. In the news, many job seekers take a break from the hunt in late November and December, figuring that employers are distracted by holiday parties, vacation plans, and end-of-year assignments like closing out the books. Although holiday spirits may be high, KPFT's Ron Reynolds spoke with employment expert Chris Lawson with the Eli Daniel Staffing Firm, who says you should keep up the job hunt.
Mr. Lawson, thank you for joining us.
My pleasure. Thanks, Ron.
This time of year, job seekers typically hit the pause button and stop looking for employment, and you're saying that's something that they should not do. Why?
Absolutely not. Number one, I don't know that you can hit the pause button on searching for employment with it being as competitive as it is, you know. So I think in this time of year in particular, really companies the last couple of weeks, they really just everything kind of slows down, and a lot of hiring managers will be, you know, at their desk, able to focus with less distractions on tasks. And a lot of those would be going through resumes and setting up interviews for the next week, for the right around the corner and stuff like that. So, you know, companies are still looking, during this time of year. And I think it's an excellent time, to gain an advantage, so to speak, for everybody that's really taken probably a little longer break than should be.
Yeah, so not everyone is on vacation, as you're pretty much saying it, and sometimes the hiring party may be at work.
Absolutely. You know, that's kind of a hit and miss thing, but when it's slower, that's when a lot of that computer work or going through the tedious type of work gets done. When things are a little bit slower, and I think sourcing resumes and visiting with candidates is one of those.
And I think it was conventional wisdom, and perhaps that it's misinformation. Typically, employers start to hire at the beginning of the year because that's when they have their new budget, and you know they're trying to reserve or save all the cash towards the end of the year for various reasons. And you're saying that could be quite the opposite.
Absolutely, and you know we run into that a lot. Where companies will have, I shouldn't say a lot, we do run into that somewhat frequently, where, you know, companies have X amount of dollars set aside for that annual budget, and if their fiscal year ends, let's say, December 31st, well, they've got dollars to spend, whether it's, say, maybe temporary assistance, where they might need somebody to come in, and a lot of times those temporary projects, you take them if you're looking for a job, because a lot of times that's your ticket right into the door. So if they, you know, if you have a 2-week project that needs to be done and they've got extra money in their budget, then you take it, and who knows what might happen around the corner. And, you know, a lot of times the companies are looking for the, for that first quarter hiring, and they're cranking down on it right now, yeah. You know, in the last couple of weeks or maybe throughout the month of December.
They may have some big assignment or project coming up at the beginning of the year, and so they're trying to fill those spots now.
That's right.
Now, typically, what's the best way? You know, I hear different opinions regarding sending emails, or, you know, and I would imagine that it varies from the type of job, but is there a certain rule in how to go about getting employed? Do you recommend email? Do you recommend,
I really, you know, there's a lot of different strategies that we like to take. And in those, in fact, if you go to EliDaniel.com, you can find a lot of, for the candidate section, it tells you, you know, strategies for job searching, not just to get in that rut where you're just, you know, you're doing the same thing. You got to change it up a little bit. And I'm a big fan of, obviously, scouring the internet and applying to all positions that, you know, a candidate is going to be qualified for. But a lot of times you'll find the company name or, let's say if it were a Craigslist ad, where they'll list the company and you can actually reply right back with an email. In those, I say don't just send your resume. If you've got an opportunity to communicate anything, you want it to be, you know, pinpoint. You've researched the company, you have specified why exactly you're qualified for the position, and you type up a good email, I guarantee you that will stand out. Because most people just send their resume. Yeah. And I always encourage people, anytime you've got an opportunity to communicate, via email, or you've got the hiring manager's name that you can get through email, then a well thought out planned email works wonders.
And are there any other tips? I know that some people tend to think that certain buzzwords would get their resume right. looked at, because
keywords are really huge, especially in the the way the job searching and the way that is filled these days. If you've done XYZ at a company, then you need to list main keywords that you see throughout your resume, because that is one of the things, whether they're looking through a list of resumes and it'll highlight that keyword, or if they're looking at a job board online, that word will be highlighted and it'll pull your resume. So it's just that's definitely, we always, with the way that, Google search and everything works, keywords are, that's where it's at. So you have to make sure your resume is filled with critical keywords that apply to your experience.
Yeah. All right, Mr. Lawson. I'm sure many people have on their wish list this holiday season a new job, and I'm sure some of the information that you've just shared will help. Appreciate you taking the time to talk to us.